Hello student, good evening. Welcome in your classroom. And today we will start with 12th class CBSE board physics book for part 1st, electric charge and field. Chapter 1st, electric charges and fields. Okay students, because we have discussed many more things related to this chapter, and also we have discussed what. So first of all, we started with electrostatic. What is the electrostatic? What is the charges? And what is the electric field? Also Coulomb's law. Also, that means we have read out many points, but and this chapter is so important in your 12th and also IIT in JAM, many more things. And this is the basic for electric fields, and also if we'll go further, then you will read our magnetic field and also electrostatic, means electric plus magnetic field. But to before start this, we have discussed our what is the electric field, and we have discussed Coulomb's law and what is the applications of these. Now we will start with electric lines. Electric field line. That today we will discuss. Today we will discuss on some points. Some points which are today point discussion. That first of all, we will discuss about the electric field line. Electric field line. Yes. Second, today we will discuss about the electric flux. What is electric flux? And third point, we will read out about the electric dipole. Electric dipole. Okay, friend, to before to start these, because these are so important points. These are so important. Please read it carefully, and if you have any doubt, please raise your hand. And if you have any that you want to discuss, maybe how am I about, why this is possible, why it is not possible, please ask me in your class as it is going on. So now, first of all, I will discuss with electric field lines. Electric field lines. Please tell me, student, because we have discussed what the charges. Yes, you know. Yes. And what? That we have discussed what is the electric field. Electric field. Electric field, that we represent it as E, is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught into Q upon R square. Means that electric field is proportional to what? 1 upon R square. Whenever the R will increase, R will be greater than what? 0. Then the electric field will decrease. Electric field decrease. Yes or no? Field is decreasing. Decreasing. But try to understand, students, it depends on the what? Electric field is depending on charge, means E is proportional to Q, and depend on the charges. However, what is the charge type? That it is positive and it is negative. Yes and no. Yes, exactly. And we have discussed the force acting, because force depend on what? F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 and Q2 upon mid R square in same procedure. Yes or no? Yes. So representing the electric field lines, that means if point charge is here, what is a point charge? A point charge is here. But we were discussing that, please tell me the at or on this charge, how much electric field is affecting, how much electric field and how much force so it is applying on this charge, that it is attractive, it is repulsive. Yes, but that if suppose that it's a point charge, it's a point charge, so that it's, you can see its area, means its area means its effect is proportional to what, r square, means whenever you will go means you will remove the point of charge, then electric field will be decreases. Yes or no? Yes. And to represent the electric field, that I am taking a what, this type of, that this is a charge and the electric field lines we are representing as arrows. What type? Arrows. And it does not depend on how many arrows then you are making, how many lines, not. It depends on the density. It depends on the density. The electric field lines depends on the what, density. However, that you will go here, you will away from the point of charge, then you will see that the density of electric field lines is decreasing. Density of electric field lines is decreasing, means that you can say that there is a point charge, that this is the whole, means dark, and the after some time it is how this type, this is what, weak, that this is dark and this is light, if we can say in this, this way. Suppose that what is this, a electric bulb is on, okay, that what you are seeing, the intensity of the light is near about some 2 and 3 meters is so high, and whenever you are going to, if you are going to in another room, then you are seeing there is coming light is so light, you're so weak. Yes or no? Means that what is that, the depend, you cannot see there the how much lines are there. No, it depends not on the lines, number of lines, it depends on the density. How much density is there of electric lines? Yes. And suppose that this I am taking a example for the understanding, that you can understand. We are talking about that electric field lines. Field lines are in 3D, but we are representing in 3D plane. That you can understand. Then suppose that I am taking a 2D dimension, okay, yes, and I am taking a cone. What cone? I am discussing about the solid angle. What is solid angle? This is O, and this is solid angle, we represent which, delta omega. Solid angle is representing delta omega. And now I am taking a surface, means that is P1, okay, and after some time that I am taking what, P2, and the same electric field lines are What? In outgoing. This time. This is P2. And this is P1. This is P2. And this OP1 is R1. And OP2 is R2. Okay. So, what we are doing that can you imagine two equal and small elements of area placed at point what? R and S. What? R and S. On this. R and S. Then my question is arise that please tell me how much electric field lines are crossing the what area surface is R and area surface is S at P1 and at P2. At P1 and P2. That the question answer will be not same. That question answer not will be same because that you know the density of electric field lines is what decrease. How decrease? The electric field lines are decreasing with the distance. With the distance. Exactly. Yes. Then you can see here the how it means the intensity or phir density of the electric field lines is greater than at the surface of R greater than at the surface on S. Yes or no? Exactly. Because whenever you will go how much distance will be increased that the density of electric field lines will be decreased because what in which ratio that is decreasing in the 1 upon r square. Yes, yes. And we know what the solid angle is. Solid angle delta omega is delta s upon r square. Delta S upon R square. That you know about this. That delta S means delta S is the what? That arc. Delta S is the arc. And what is this? R square. R square. So that you can see here that at P1, at point P1, at point P1. How much it's going on that at P1 delta S here what delta at P1 P1 point means what R1 square into delta omega and at P2 how much R2 square into delta omega how much angle it is this is delta omega. That you can depend then you can and the strength of the field clearly what strength of the electric field is what 1 upon r square dependency yes Hema yes so so that we can say a electric field line in general a curve drawn in such a way that the tangent to each point in the direction of the net field at the point yes yes now I will tell the four points about the electric field lines what first point what is if the point charge if the point charge is positive what is positive point charge is positive suppose that I am representing it what wait point charge is positive plus q that how that how the represent of the electric field lines this will be outgoing means outward. Hamesha plus Q charge means that direction will be positive to negative. Direction will be positive to negative, and it's a very important lines. Okay, very important. If the second point is the charge is negative, charge is negative, then how you will what inward. Inward, because direction is what? Positive to negative. So that will be any charge will be where the positive here. So negative, that the electric field lines will be what? Inward, not outward, inward. And if third point is if two charges are putting nearby, suppose that positive, okay, okay, see, then what you are seeing here, the in this distance, that what you will feel here, they must be cross. No, they will never cross. Then how it will be behave? They will be behave just like it is a positive and positive. But what they will do? They will kya? Repulse. Repulsion is here, so that the electric field lines will be this type and this type. That you can see what is happening here. Repulsion. Yes or no? And positive charges is here. That positive to negative, that the direction will be how type? This outward. Outward. See, outward. Yes or no? Now suppose that if same case is here, negative charge is here, then what you will feel? Same process will be, because why? The electric field lines will be what? Inward. Yes or no? Yes. Inward. But in fourth case, if positive charge is here and negative charge is here, then how you will feel here? That both are attractive. Yes or no? Means attraction is here. So the electric field lines that you will see, electric field lines will be which one type that you can see? And what is positive charge? For positive charge, electric field line will be what? Outward? Yes. Outward. And? Yes, outward. And for this negative charge, what? Inward. 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 That you can understand, yes and no, yes, because this one practical that I think you will, if you have not done it at this time in your 12th class practicals, but if you will go after some time, the first chapter is going on in classroom, then you will do the practical that you will feel it here, that you are taking one what, a magnet, and one is compass, that is that show the direction of the, that what you will see, that two charges will be given here, positive and negative, exactly means two magnets, they're both same, what, one is north and one is south, means okay, N and S poles are here. Then if you are taking the both poles, then you will see that the electric field lines will be, curve will be same in this type, curve will be same in this type, then you can understand this one diagram will be feel if you will do the practical in your notebook. So please write down the four points, so these are so important to related the electric field line, that's why I am just telling you. Yeah, I am writing here the electric field follow some important points, which are number one, just I am writing here, the field lines starts, field lines start from positive charge to negative charge, and positive charge start from positive charge to end at end if there is a single charge, they may start or end at infinity. Okay. Number second is, if in a charge-free region, what? Charge-free region, that electric field lines can be taken to be continuous curves. Continuous curves without any breaks. Number third is, two field lines can never cross each other. Okay. Two field lines can static field lines don't form any closed loop. Okay, this follows the only conservative nature of electric field. Then we will study in our next. So these are the most important about the electric field. Some important points, and please keep in your mind. It's so important. Okay, a field lines start from what? Positive, and ends on the negative. And if there is a single charge, then they may be start and end at infinity. If a in a charge free region, that electric field lines can be taken to be continuous curve without any break, and two, yeah, please keep in your mind, and two field lines can never cross each other. What? Can never cross each other. Okay, this was these all knowledge about the electric field line. I think this is enough, and please keep in your mind when you are starting with the electric field chapter. Now the second point, what was mine? The second point was electric flux. Electric flux. What is electric flux? Okay. I am just telling you what that, how can you understand? Suppose that you have taken in your hand what a pipe of water, and you are crossing with a what? Suppose that you are taking a ring. Okay, a small pipe is here in your hand, and you are taking in a ring. And ring is what? It is just in a shape of the pipe. Then what you will see, that the how much intensity that water is coming, that the that will be flow from the ring, that it is going how much intensity, means that is coming that 10 kilometer per second speed, yeah, 10 meter per second speed, then that the water is flowing from the ring, that is 10 meter per second. But when you are tilt the ring, then what you are seeing, that you will see the some part of water that will be go in another direction, and the some part will be go in which you, that you want to collect the water in which pot. Yes or no? Yes. Then what is the behaving is here, the after the tilt, after the tilt. So that's for in same case electric flux. I am just telling you, consider a liquid, flow of liquid with velocity is v, okay, and a small flat surface is here ds, in a direction normal to the surface. Normal to the surface means if you are just taking in your hold in pipe in your hand, that the ring is already that you taking in same normal to the direction. Then what you will see, that rate of flow liquid is given the volume crossing the area per unit. Yes and no? Yes. Area per unit. Area per unit. Area per unit. That you can understand what is this point? Yes. Please understood. Area. If velocity is v, and the area surface of what pipe is ds, okay, and you are taking as what normal to the surface, that the area is area, what is area? Area is length into breadth. Yes and no? Yes. Velocity, that v into ds, that the area will be A into V into ds. So V into ds. But suppose that if the normal to the surface is not parallel to the direction of flow, it makes an angle. Means this was a pipe and this is a ring. Okay. Now at this time that it is flowing with this area of surface VDS. Okay. But now pipe is same, but ring is this type. Ring is this type, trilled. It's making some angle. Then how much it will be? That it will be made with angle that VDS cos theta, area per unit. The flux going on or the surface, and this is representing flux. Flux is what? The area flux going out of the surface ds is v dot n cap with ds. N cap is unit direction. For the case of electric field, we define as the among the quantity and call it electric flux. Okay. And I will tell you one more thing about the electric flux. Okay, suppose that I am giving you one more example that a small planar, okay, a small planar element I am taking this. I am just not telling you what is type of this one. Okay, just I am telling you this area is delta S. Delta S. Okay. And how much electric field lines are going on this? This. Okay. This one. At point E. The number of field lines is crossing, it is proportional to that. I am telling you how much electric field lines is crossing this field, then you will be told that E into delta S. Yes and no? Yes. E into delta S. Now suppose we tilt the area. What we are tilting this area, this is crossing at this time, but now what I am doing here, I tilt this area, this, then what you will feel here, the tilted area is, the projection of the area element is what? In this direction, what will be? Suppose that this is theta, that what you will get, that E delta S, what is? This is the delta S, then what will the delta S cos of theta, and in this direction, it will be delta S sin theta. Yes or no? Yes. The projection and the what now my question is the how much number of lines, field lines are crossing this delta S area, then your answer will be what? E into delta S into cos theta. Yes and no? Yes. Suppose that if the parallel means the lines are what the solid angle is, the surface area is parallel. Means theta is 90 degree, that cos 90 degree value will, theta is 90 degree, that is cos 90 is 0, that how much lines will be go, means suppose that the this one area is how is this type, it is not flowing any electric field lines, there is no flowing any electric line, The orientation of area element are not merely in magnitude, it's important in many contexts. For example, just I'm giving you, in a stream, the amount of water flowing through a ring will naturally depend on how you hold the ring, correct? If you hold it in normal to the flow, that the maximum water will flow through it. Then if you hold it with the some other method or some other orientation, that the so the area element should be treated as a vector. The magnitude and also a direction. Yes and no? Yes. So we need come to define the definition of electric flux. The electric flux, we define the delta phi. What? Delta phi. And delta phi is E dot delta S. This is the dot product, that dot product which we remove, and you will define the E delta S cos theta. This is the electric flux. Electric flux. And now theta may be anything. The how much you are tilt. You are how much tilt the surface area. Suppose that you are tilting the theta is 45 degree. That cos 45 degree value what? Cos 45 degree value is what? 1 upon root 2. That the what area will be the electric field lines means electric pulse flux will be E into delta S upon root 2. Upon root 2. The what? The comparison with the, if you are taking in the what? In the same, in the normal to the plane orientation, then. So, I am just telling you the electric flux definition. What is electric flux definition? And it depends on the what? Solid. Okay. It depends on the area of the solid and what type of this. Suppose that, just I am telling you two more things about that. The direction of the area element is along its normal, but a normal can point in two directions. Yes and no. Which direction to we choose as the direction of the vector associated with the area element? This problem is all resolved by the two some convention approximate to the given context. For the case one, that is the closed surface. What is a closed surface? This convention is very simple. The vector associated with every area element of closed surface is taken to be the direction of the outward normal. This is convention used. This is convention used. Outward area, and what is it? This is a closed area, surface area. There is this, and this is what? Delta S, and this is making suppose a theta angle, and outward. What? A small element of area, surface area. What? Surface area. Wait. Electric flux. What is a small element? Element of surface area. Surface area. What is delta S? The electric field lines, which are making the angle what theta. Defined as normal to the surface element, the flux through the element is equal to what is that delta phi is equal to E delta S cos of theta. Delta S cos of theta, and we can represent in a what? In a integration law. That is, we will discuss in your next class or next chapter, that we will discuss that how can we represent in a flux in a integral form when delta is tending to zero. Okay students, that this was the knowledge about the what? Electric flux. Now what is this? Is the surface area. What is this type of closed surface area, and what normal to the surface? Not to the surface, is going to outside. Now the third point is today discussion is on electric dipole. What? Electric dipole. Before to start the electric dipole, just I want to tell you how it is making the electric dipole. Just what is this? That suppose that you are taking what? Two charges. What? Two charges, but not same charges. We are taking the both charges. Different charges means positive Q and negative Q, both are different charges, and in this direction that if I will just tell you the how much total charge, then you will tell the total charge of positive Q and negative Q, that is making the equation zero. Yes, but this is correct, but what? An electric dipole is a pair of two equal and opposite point charges, yes, plus Q and negative Q, and separated by a distance. How much? That we are taking 2a. What is 2a? Convention of direction from minus Q to Q. The direction will be of dipole will be minus Q to Q, said to be direction of the dipole. The midpoint of the location of minus Q and Q is called the center of the dipole. The total charge of electric dipole is obviously zero. Yes. How much? Total charge of electric dipole is obviously zero. How much? Zero. That you can understand what we are doing, what we are saying electric dipole. What we are not talking about the only one charge, we are talking about the both charges, positive and both charges are making a what? Dipole. Then you can understand dipole poles. Two poles means that we are taking the two point charges. And two point charges, both are what? Equally same charges, but direction means one is positive and one is negative. That this type of the positive and negative charges, both charges will make a what? Dipole. Okay, an electric dipole is a pair of equal and opposite Q and minus Q. And between distance is 2a. Okay, the two charges define the direction in space, and the electric dipole, what? Electric dipole direction is, I am writing here, electric dipole direction is negative to positive, मतलब minus Q to plus Q. Okay, electric dipole direction will be minus q to plus q, and c to be the direction of the dipole, and the midpoint of the location of minus q and q, midpoint will be say what? Center of dipole. Center of dipole. And the total charge that we have just told, what will be the positive q and minus q, what is making that is zero. That is making zero. Obviously zero. This does not mean the field of electric dipole will be zero. It does not mean that the total electric dipole field is not zero. Since the charges q and minus q are separately by some distance, yes, the electric field due to them when the separate of the two charges forming a dipole, the field due to q to minus q nearly cancel out. The electric field due to a dipole therefore at a large distance 1 upon r square, the dependency of the qualitative variance. Okay? Yes. Like what is the electric dipole? The two point charges are making the dipole, not only single one, and both must be what? Indifferent. Means A, one is positive and one is negative. The total charge of electric dipole is obviously zero positive and q negative q, but the field of the electric dipole is not zero. This is not zero. Means we are talking about electric field, then we are just, it's the same case, the positive and negative will be cancelled out. But in the electric dipole field, positive q and negative q, that's all. And positive q and negative q, a distance is taken here between them, that is 2a. That is 2a means at the center of midpoint is dipole, we will say the center of dipole, midpoint. That is, midpoint is the distance will be positive q will be a and negative q will be distance a. But between them distance is 2a, we are taking is here 0.